lion cubs and woolly lambs and big fat fuzzy bears. Holy poly elephants lipping with a hare. Monkeys climbing tall giraffes and tickling their ribs. Heaven is a happy place and heaven is for kids.
Just in case you're getting old and think you cannot go,
I hear they don't check wrinkles there or hair that's white like snow.
In fact, the way I hear it, they welcome you right in.
And just before you know it, you'll be a kid again. Singing songs with angel choirs
or eating angel food.
Running around the countryside
or city streets of gold.
Your imagination then begin to comprehend.
That's right.
Heaven is a happy place and heaven is for kids. Heaven is a happy place and heaven is for kids.
Good morning, boys and girls, and happy Sabbath. It's me again, your Auntie Jung, and with me today is my little girl, Chloe. We are excited today to learn more lessons from our 28 fundamental beliefs. We are now on our 19th lesson and we have 9 more to go. Last Sabbath, Auntie Cindy talked about the gift of prophecy, and today we will be learning about the law of God. Our story today is entitled
Signs.
Have you ever noticed how many signs there are beside the road?
Last time, we were driving a car going to the grocery shop. And I took my cell phone and take a picture of some of the signs in the street. Can you read them with me?
Okay.
So how about this sign? This sign looks like a diamond. And it's color yellow with red, yellow, and green.
What is it?
What is it? Yes, you're right. It's traffic sign ahead.
That's right.
What about this one?
Oh.
This looks like an octagon.
Mm-hmm.
And it's STOP. Let's see what it says.
Mm-hmm.
Good job! It's stop!
It's a stop sign. Yes, good job.
How about this sign?
Mm-hmm. What's that?
Yes, you're correct. It's school zone ahead.
That's right. And next?
How about this one? This looks like P.
What is it?
What is it, everybody? Yeah, you're right. It says no parking.
No parking sign. That's right.
How about this one?
Mm-hmm.
It's that arrow is pointing to a direction.
Yeah. What is
what
that? What is that direction?
Yeah. What is it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you're right. It's left turn ahead.
Very good. And the next?
This looks like a U, but upside down.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try to see what that is. Yes, you're correct. It says,
No, your turn ahead. Yeah, that's right. And the last one?
How about this one? Mm-hmm. This is the last. Great job, everybody. That's so easy. It says, do not enter.
Very good.
Mama, why is there so many signs in the street?
Mm-hmm, yeah, that's a good question.
Only a foolish people can drive the wrong way or go really fast when it's red light.
Yeah, you have a point there. But you know what, Chloe? Signs aren't just for foolish people. Sometimes normal, safe drivers make mistakes and aren't as careful as they should be. The highway department puts these signs up to remind everyone how to stay safe and arrive home all in one piece. The signs aren't just for people who break laws. they help law keepers know what to do so they can drive better and safer. That's exactly what God's laws do as well.
God's laws?
Yes, Chloe, God's laws. The Ten Commandments. It helps us to know right from wrong. They teach us how to live when the devil tries to confuse us with lies and false promises. Just think of God's Ten Commandments as signs along the road of life.
It's as weird as like you and Papa, you give us rules. Before we cross the street, we look left and right before we cross safely. Mm-hmm. Or do not hit my brother or sister.
Yeah, because?
Because you love us and you give us rules because you know what's best for us.
Oh, yes, that's right, Chloe. The Ten Commandments reveal God's will and love for us. Its guidelines tell how to relate to God and others. Remember, as you hear each commandment, that they are all equally important. One is not more important than the other.
Okay, the first
commandment
is put God first.
Yes, the first commandment is to put God first. This means that nothing should be more important than God. A hobby you enjoy, TV or video games, even your friends and family should not be more important than God. Law number two
is worship only God.
Yes, the second commandment is to worship only God. This is like the first commandment in that God wants our love, and He doesn't want us to bow down and worship a statue just because we can't see Him. In other words, God is the only one that we should pray to.
The third commandment says, don't.
You must not use the name of the Lord our God thoughtlessly or in vain. The third commandment is broken all the time. God commands us to use His name with respect. Many people use God's name like a swear word or say it when they're upset. God wants us to use His name when we are talking to Him or telling others about Him in a nice way. To use His name in this other ways is very disrespectful and hurts God to hear it.
The fourth commandment is rest on the seventh day and keep it holy.
Yes, the fourth commandment should be easy. We are to remember God's Sabbath. God wants us to take one day of the week and rest. When God made the world in
6 days.
6 days, He rested on the
seventh day.
This gets harder when you get older. There always seems to be something to do, but remember, God commands us to take one day off.
Okay, the fifth commandment is honor your mother and father.
Yeah, the fifth commandment might be a little tricky for some of you, but it's very important, like all the other commandments, that you follow it. It tells us to respect our parents. Sometimes you might think you know what's best, or you get frustrated because your parents won't let you do something. Remember, your parents were once kids just like you, and they are trying to keep you safe and from making the same mistakes they've already made.
Okay.
Which commandment is next, Ate Chloe?
It's number six.
Yes, the sixth commandment.
And it says, never hurt anyone.
Never hurt anyone. This commandment says, don't hurt others. Now imagine for a minute if everyone in the whole world obeyed this rule like God wants us to do. We probably won't have any jails and we would all get along with one another.
Okay, the seventh commandment is keep
wedding
promises.
The seventh commandment is for those who are married. God tells us to be faithful in marriage. He wants us to love our wife or husband someday, even if they get on your nerves once in a while, and treat them with respect.
Okay, the eighth commandment is don't steal.
Don't steal. This means that we shouldn't take something that doesn't belong to us. We are almost done.
This is now commandment number 9. This one says, tell the truth.
Yeah, always tell the truth. You don't tell a lie. It is always better to tell the truth, and while you are at it, don't do anything that would make you want to lie. Usually, parents know when you're lying anyway, and if you don't get caught, God sees and hears everything, and He knows. And the last one?
It says, it's the 10th commandment, and it says, don't wish for your... For other people's
stuff. Yeah. What is an example for that, Ate Chloe?
Well, it was my neighbor Koi Kayo's birthday, and he had so many Lego, and there was also dinosaurs in there, and I want that too, but Mama said that we cannot buy it because we don't have extra money.
And then what else? And you also, you have a lot of
toys, so Mama said that maybe on your birthday you can have pony toys or other toys in your birthday.
So it is important that we are be contented of what we already have. It is important to remember that these things aren't really important. God is the most important. Now I know this list might seem impossible to follow all the time. How about you, Chloe? Do you think you will be able to follow God's commandments for us?
Yes, with God's help.
Very good, Chloe. Yes, you are right. With God's help, you and I will. Another thing to remember is that if you disobey a commandment, God sees the smallest lie just the same as if someone hurts someone really bad. I know sometimes we think if we just told a little lie, it wouldn't matter or God wouldn't notice. But it does matter, and God does notice. It makes Him sad when we disobey Him. So when we make a mistake, we need to say
sorry
to God and to the person you've wronged, and try to be a better person next time. God loves to hear from kids. Jesus Christ made time for children. He pointed out their good examples, and He will help you. He can guide you by His Holy Spirit being with you. He can lead you to the time when you are ready as an adult to make the lifetime commitment of baptism. From then on, God's Holy Spirit will not just be with you, but in you. For our memory verse, it's found in 1 John 5:3.
This is love for God, to obey His commands.
Thank you, boys and girls, for listening, and hope to see you next Sabbath for our 20th Fundamental Beliefs to be shared by Ate Jel.
Goodbye! Happy Sabbath!